Hey everyone, Kelly Kroll here with a Coors Light Cold Hard Facts Sportsnet Central update. Coming up tonight at 6:30, we'll have highlights and post-game reaction from the Cubs after their battle with the Pirates here. Plus, we're live at U.S. Cellular Field to preview the White Sox and the Bo Sox. That and all the day's news coming your way on Sportsnet Central. But for now, let's head back to Pittsburgh where Lynn and JD are standing by. Guys.
Kelly. Thank you, Kelly, and we'd like to welcome all our viewers watching on Wellman Cooperative Telephone Company in Wellman, Iowa. Here's Jason Rogers.
Return home for a long homestand. The Pirates will be heading out of town for a long three-city trip. St. Louis, Cincinnati, and then they'll come to Chicago. So back-to-back starts, John Lester has worked out of bases loaded, nobody out situations without allowing a run.
Baez gets the pitch hitter, Rogers.
Budweiser Patio offers fans an all-inclusive Budweiser bleacher experience in prime home run territory right down the right field line. This outdoor semi-private space opens 2 hours prior to the game and is perfect for corporate outings, client events, family gatherings. For more on all the available outdoor spaces located in the Budweiser bleachers, visit cubs.com/premier.
A pierogi race. I don't think they've done it yet, right? They're just preparing.
I honestly don't know. I usually you know, lock in on that. It's working the crowd a little bit. Say, hey, don't worry, folks. Everything's gonna be okay here. We got running pierogies, running sausages, running presidents. The running legends in Arizona. What's next?
The garlic fries race. Baez lets it go. Russell's got to hurry. Out at first.
Well, with John Lester on the mound, you expect some action for the left side of the infield. Baez made a very nice play to start the inning. Now Russell closes on this one, slings it on over to barely get Mercer. Tricky little in between hop.
And it is being challenged. So it is time for the Forsyth Technology replay review.
By that look we just had at it, looked to me like it was inconclusive. I just flashed one on the big board. Not surprisingly, the fans here in Pittsburgh think he was safe.
Not look overturnable.
I'm with you.
To me, yeah.
But we have seen a number of plays that have been, what we felt was in that category of not conclusive to overturn that have been overturned. And while John Lester will throw a few pitches just to make sure he stays loose. It's not a hot day, but there's a little humidity, a little mugginess in the air here today. call stands. See, they overruled it.
I didn't see that, but what? I was wrong. Here's McCutcheon.
You notice McCutcheon when he comes up to hit, how he kind of tips his hat? Notice that the last couple of nights. He's tipping his hat to the umpire or somebody behind home plate. So superstition, not sure. That's hit 6 home runs this year. Hit one the other night off Jason Hamill. He had a 3 home run game earlier this year. Still hasn't really found his groove yet. You know he will. Going deep, any part of the ballpark.
Any pitch?
McCutcheon hit 23 long balls last year. Career best 31 in
Zobrist will run it down, and that overturn on the replay looming potentially pretty large here. They've got runners at first and third with one out.
Now normally down 4 runs, you're thinking, well, they're not going to run here. Freeze has power. Marte's got power. They don't hit a lot of home runs, but both capable. So normally you're thinking, nah, don't take any chances on the bases, but, you know,
they've had so little going, too.
Yeah, and you know, Freeze, again, he hits the ball on the ground a lot. That would be a big concern for me if I'm Clint Hurdle. McCutcheon, when he first came into the league, stole a bunch of bases, but he's had some injury problems, and they just don't, you know, they don't want to put him in harm's way. He's such a valuable guy. He stole 11 bases last year in 16 tries. Just 1 out of 3 so far this season. It's that outside edge, just beyond strike. If you're Lester, you're feeling like you should be able to dictate this at bat now. No balls, 2 strikes.
Swing and a miss for strike 3. Only his 4th strikeout today.
cheddar there, and it, you know, effectively changing the eye level. He does so much work down, that can be an effective pitch, but he does run one up like that.
Outside on Marte. I guess the tipping of the batting helmet is to his wife.
Okay.
And I guess Jackie Robinson used to do that, although the score says it would be after a home run. So maybe he does it now every time he comes to the plate.
Well, he did it when he hit the home run the other night, too. You see that he did it when he crossed home plate. But I've noticed him doing it as he comes up to hit as well. So I didn't know that. That's a good little factoid. Yeah. So Jackie Robinson had that little move right there. Social place in all of sport than first base, and you know, the base runner and the first baseman down there gabbing away. I'm guessing that linemen in the NFL don't chat it up very much.
It would be awkward if those guys didn't talk, wouldn't it? Still 2-2. Sean Casey's kind of widely known as called the mayor. Really talking up guys after they reach first base.
See Willie Stargell back in the day get a little tic-tac-toe game going with the other first baseman. He'd draw the grid out there on the infield dirt.
That's great. Always find a Willie Stargell jersey in the stands here in Pittsburgh. Pops. Two outs. McCutchen will be on the move here. Rizzo playing behind him.
Lester working in a few more breaking balls, trying to give these Pirate hitters a different look. I also remember going to see the Pirates at, who was it, Jerry Park, way back in the day, before a Sunday a doubleheader, and they were taking infield without a ball, doing the Phantom infield practice. That was a lot of fun. It's amazing how quick they could turn that double play when there was no ball.
Yeah. Swing and a miss, so Lester gets out of this jam. They have stranded five over the last two innings. The Hall of Famer, Willie Stargell.
Introducing Comcast Business Wi-Fi Pro with next-level speed, coverage, marketing, and control features. Plus, Wi-Fi Pro offers what AT&T's Wi-Fi small site doesn't: professional installation, advanced security, and millions of hotspots nationwide. Looks like taking your business to the next level starts with ditching AT&T. Give your business an edge with Comcast Business Wi-Fi Pro. Comcast Business, built for business.
Something doesn't feel right.
Green lights across the board. What's going on up there?
No backup system. Houston will fly solo here.
Does he have it?
I'm on it. Re-entry in 3, 2, 1.
care package, Houston. Dinner's on me. Just another day in the rocket biz. Oh, fudge nuggets.
Honda knows that efficiency has its advantages. That's why the Honda CR-V can help you get places using less fuel. Gives you a better view of your surroundings. And helps you stay in touch while you're on the road. The CR-V, from KBB.com's best value brand. Nothing compares to a Honda. So visit your local Honda dealer today.
Wednesday, May 11th, the Chicago Fire Soccer Club plays on CSN Plus. Stay glued to your TV as the men in red fight for a win over the Whitecaps. Coverage starts at 8:30 next Wednesday on CSN Plus.
Goes first to third. Rogers, who pinch hit, now playing first. And a veteran right-hander, Ryan Vogelsong, 38 years old. Second tour with the Pirates. He was here from 03 to 06. He has made one start. This is his sixth relief appearance. Two stints with the Giants, two with the Pirates, with a big gap in the middle. 07 to 10, pitched in Japan. Quite a comeback story, as he was an all-star with the Giants in his return to the major leagues in 2011. 2-0 to Fowler.
Fastball, slider, curve, and change for Vogelsong. Won't overpower you with velocity.
Rainbow to left. Marte's got it. Make sure you follow In Game Live on CSNChicago.com, presented by State Farm. Tommy La Stella. It was cool but pleasant Wednesday afternoon.
Oh, do you know that today is the anniversary of the first major league game ever played? According to Baseball Reference, 1871, May the 4th, the National Association contest between the Cleveland Forest Cities and the Fort Wayne Kekiongas. K-E-K-I-O-N-G-A-S.
Wow. Bunted foul by La Stella.
'69, the first professional team, all professional team, the Cincinnati Red Stockings, started their season with a 45-9 win over the Great Westerns of Cincinnati. The club had no pitching. No, he didn't. Yes, he did.
And La Stella is out.
Cub fans, join the Cubs season ticket holder waiting list. Do it today. Claim your spot in our lineup for season tickets. It's easy. And it's free to register. For details, visit Cubs.com/waiting list. If you are in the market for a pitcher, Tim Lincecum is going to hold a showcase on Friday out in Scottsdale. Been talking about that for a while now, but apparently all systems go. A bunch of teams are expected to be on hand.
I've read it, including the Cubs, as they always do their due diligence. It's pronounced Kikianga.
Kikianga?
It was the name of a Native American settlement. As Bryant flies to McCutchen. And the Cubs go down quietly for the first time in order.
Paint? No, this isn't just paint. This is the most advanced one coat coverage. Made with molecules that bond stronger, bond tighter, and bond tougher in one coat. For beauty that starts and stays that way. Because this isn't just paint. This is Paramount. New and exclusively at Menards.
Weeknights, don't miss Sports Talk Live on Comcast Sportsnet. David Kaplan leads a roundtable on the day's hottest topics, interviews Chicago's biggest stars, and interacts with you at home. Sports Talk Live, presented by Chevy Silverado, tonight at 5:30 on Comcast Sports.
I came as fast as I could. What's up?
This isn't public yet.
What isn't?
We've been attacked.
The network?
Shh.
When did this happen?
Over the last 6 months.
How did we miss it?
We caught it, just not in time.
Who? How?
Not sure. Probably offshore.
Foreign?
Pros.
What did they get?
What didn't they get?
I need to call Mike.
Don't use your phone.
It's not just security. It's defense. BAE Systems.
This is Anthony Rizzo, all-star first baseman for the Chicago Cubs. When he's not playing baseball, he's reading about baseball.
God, he's so good.
When he's not reading about baseball, he's listening to baseball. When he's not listening to baseball,
what's up, boys?
He's watching live baseball.
Jonesy. Ooh, that's deep.
Ooh. And when he's not watching live baseball, he's playing baseball. MLB.com at bat, the number one app for live baseball.
Sports Talk Live at CSN's David Kaplan hosts live from Wrigley Field. Cap and friends will help preview the Cup Series with the Nationals. Don't miss Sports Talk Live presented by Chevy Silverado tomorrow at 5 on CSN Chicago.
So Belly bounces to third. And one out.
Jake Arrieta got 13 outs on the ground in the ball game last night. Mister doing some good work in that regard. Got 5 punch outs. He's had to work hard here today. Pirates have had a fair number of base runners, but they've not been able to break through. Dogged determination when you watch John Lester pitch, man. He is intense, committed. Does not like to give in.
Happy 13th birthday to Will Martin. Swing and a miss. 1-1.
That's it.
Oof. Better feel for that curveball. Rodriguez had the first crack at Lester in the fourth with the bases loaded and nobody out, and he struck out. Offered out a fastball that was off the plate and up a little bit.
Cup fans, Henry Callahan, Howard King watching. One and two to Rodriguez. So Zobrist over near the foul line, and he makes the catch in fair territory.
Treat your clients and guests to an all-inclusive suite experience this season at Wrigley Field on the Nuveen Investment Suite level. Businesses and individuals alike find suites to be the perfect private setting to host their guests. To book your premier experience at the ballpark, visit Cubs.com/premier.
Harrison 1-for-2.
Are playing in New York. 8-0 Metropolitans. Braves have managed just one hit in that game. Steven Matz pitching for New York today. Kid Whistler pitched to Danny for Atlanta last night against the Mets.
There continue to be rumblings about Freddy Gonzalez's job security.
Barring a miraculous comeback, will fall to 7-20. But they were not expected to be good, and unfair to Freddie if they let him go. See, and we're talking, it's been a bit of an issue around the game, people talking about teams tanking, losing on purpose to better their position in the draft. And you came up with a great idea about receiving your.
Well, my thought was, if you're trying to give teams an incentive to win as many games as possible, you take the 20 non-playoff teams each year and you reverse the draft order. Best record gets the first pick. Base hit to left for Harrison. And it actually might create some final weekend drama for a team that doesn't make the playoffs.
Yeah, I think that's a great idea.
So you try to win to get that first pick instead of lose at the end of the year. I don't know, just an idea.
To send an email to the commissioner.
I don't have his email. Is it rmanfred@mlb.com? I don't know.
Bossman Rob at MLB.
Espazio out to talk with Lester before his 100th pitch. Adam Warren is up. It's a Bob Nightingale story, USA Today, regarding Freddy Gonzalez. The quote, the Braves, embarrassed over their horrific start, are internally discussing whether they should fire manager Freddy Gonzalez, a high-ranking Braves official told USA Today Sports.
Well, a lot of times in baseball, when there's smoke, there's fire, pardon the pun. But not always. Remember, there's so much talk about Brad Ausmus. It seemed like it was going to be a given that Brad was going to be let go. Tigers decided to hang on.
Speculation's gone even further than that. Runner goes and Polanco fouls. Later in the story, Bud Black considered the favorite if they hire a permanent manager. It says the Braves likely would go with an interim candidate for the rest of this season. They're opening their new ballpark next year. Two and one.
Polanco's nickname is El Cafe, like coffee. And apparently he got it from a coach when he was a kid in the Dominican Republic, because he looked like another guy who had the nickname El Cafe. So there's no great story behind it. Somebody else had the nickname, and he reminded him of that other player.
Three and one on him. Cubs lead 4-0 here in the sixth. Runner goes again. Ball four. And that will do it for the starter. Lester had to work really hard the last two innings. Bases loaded, no outs in the fourth. Couple men on. One out in the fifth. And both times he got out of it, but he will not have a chance to get out of this situation. And we will return to Pittsburgh in the sixth with the Cubs leading 4-0.
No thanks, I have X1 from Xfinity, so.
Don't fall for DirecTV. Xfinity lets you download your shows from anywhere. Sign up today or get started with this great offer. Call or go online today.
I used to like that song.
It's the Mesmerizing McGriddles. Try your choice of bacon, egg, and cheese, sausage, or sausage, egg, and cheese with a small McCafe coffee and hash browns for just $4 at McDonald's.
T-Mobile hit it out of the park. We doubled our LTE coverage to cover over 305 million Americans. And our new extended range LTE goes two times farther and works four times better in buildings than before. Switch to T-Mobile for major league coverage today.
Danleys is offering you a free garage door opener with the purchase of any garage. With over 200,000 satisfied customers since 1959, Danleys is the best garage builder in Chicago for price, quality, and service. So call today and get your free garage door opener with the purchase of any garage. 773-GARAGES.
Building your garage with quality, depend on Danleys. That's why we're number one.
It is the Midas Tire and Auto Service Experts pitching change, and here's Adam Warren, and he will not face Jason Rogers. John Jasel will pinch hit.
Yeah, a move I'm sure Joe Madden anticipated, but he likes Warren against both right and left-handed hitters. He's got a good changeup, good command of the fastball. So far, so good. He's been rock solid here in a Cub uniform. This is appearance number 9. In 9 innings, he has struck out 10. And those old adages a lot of managers go by, you're going to let a guy escape one jam, possibly two jams, but this is the third time they're put in that crisis situation. Fatigue starting to kick in. Why not get a fresh arm? 5 2/3 for Lester today, 8 hits, a couple of walks, 5 strikeouts, no runs, but responsible for 2 base runners.
To Jaso, the pitch bounced foul.
Thank you.
Rocco just walked. That ended Lester's day. Harrison off of the distance at second. He singled to keep this inning alive. And now it's Jaso, the pinch hitter. 2-1. Jaso kind of fits the Cubs' hitting philosophy. He is not in any hurry. He waits for his pitch. Not an anxious hitter by any stretch. Take his walks.
The hitters will tell you they go up there looking for either a certain pitch or in a certain location until they get two strikes, and they have to be willing to be a little more reactive and not sit on any one pitch or any location.
Ground ball, it's Rizzo to the bag unassisted, and the inning is over. Shutout intact for now. We go to the seventh. It's 4-0 Cubs.
Shards.
It's time to dehibernate at the Bass Pro Shop's Big Short Takeover with a huge selection of men's and ladies' shorts starting under $10 to $17.
Make your day supreme with Dunkin's new Bacon Supreme Omelet Breakfast Sandwich, loaded with peppers, onions, and potatoes, and topped with two slices of Cherrywood smoked bacon and cheese, all on a freshly baked croissant. America runs on Dunkin'.
Just announced from Ford. 0% financing for 60 months. And now, for a limited time, get an extra $1,000 smart bonus cash on Edge and Explorer. Ford, America's best-selling brand, now with a great offer. 0% financing for 60 months and an extra $1,000 smart bonus cash. Supplies are limited, so hurry while selection is best and see your local Ford dealer today.
We are here at Benny's Beverage Depot, and Joe, it's amazing how many good young players arrived to the Cubs at the same time. Have you ever seen anything quite like that?
I've been in some good organizations, California Angels, the Anaheim Angels, and then eventually the Rays in Tampa Bay, and I've had a lot of really good young players, but not the numbers or the quality that exists right now, and then their ability to play at such a high level and at such a young age with the lack of experience.
It's just so much fun to play good teams. It really is. And, you get to, like I said, you get them on the field from the dugout, then you look out there, how do we stack up? What does this thing feel like? I mean, you look on TV, you look at, you read different things, but you got to actually see it, and then what does it feel like? How do we match up with this thing? And so that's always important to do. And, of course, we've had two nice nights here. We've done well in St. Louis. Already we've done okay against Milwaukee and Cincinnati, so it's good to get a feel for the rest of the division in spite of the fact we've had some injuries.
If the Cubs win this game and they're leading 4-0, they would be 13-2 against their own division. Vogelsong to Rizzo, ball one. Jaso chat with Brandon Hyde, the Cubs first base coach. 1-0 is hit in the air, deep right center, back toward the wall, gone, just got it out into the first row, number 9 for Rizzo. And what a series he's had.
Yeah, the main ingredient is really on a nice roll here. You know, I think it was in Cincinnati. And I was thinking, he's not going to want to leave Cincinnati. Well, for everywhere he performs well, he's not going to leave. There's just not enough Rizzos to go along, to go around. There's your Ford home run replay. The big guy gets extended. And there's number 9. Remember, he banged it off the wall last time.
Zobrist for the homer earlier. He grounds out to first, 3-1. And it's time for the Cubs' upcoming game schedule, brought to you by Travel Wisconsin. Plan your fun today at travelwisconsin.com. 4 with the Nationals, featuring Bryce Harper. JD mentioned had been kind of cold as of late. He's 1-2 with a run and an RBI so far today in Kansas City. Nationals lead 6-2. They get all their runs in the first as they play the top of the third.
Rizzo now tied for the league lead in home runs by players not playing for the Rockies. Arenado and Story have 11 and 10 respectively.
5-0 lead. Broken bat flare that will hold up and be caught by Marte. The barrel of that bat ended up past third base in foul territory.
Doobie.
Russell's reached all three times at the plate. Not this time, though, it appears, as Polanco makes the catch. Rizzo with a leadoff homer, and it's now 5-0 as we hit the stretch.
Oh, turned up my jam. I'm feeling woke. Oh, found our chill.
Close enough.
Try the deliciously juicy Daily Double, now only $2.19 at McDonald's.
Yeah, I'm married. Doesn't matter. You do that for me? Really? Yeah, I'd like that.
Who are you talking to?
It's Jake from State Farm. Sounds like a really good deal.
Jake from State Farm at 3 in the morning? Who is this?
It's Jake from State Farm.
What are you wearing, Jake from State Farm?
Khakis.
She sounds hideous.
Well, she's a guy, so.
Another reason more people stay with State Farm. Get to a better state.
I could get used to this.
I could get used to this.
The luxuriously transformed 2016 Lexus ES and ES Hybrid.
I can get used to this.
Once you experience this level of luxury,
I can get used to this.
There's no going back.
It's the mesmerizing McGriddles. Try your choice of bacon, egg, and cheese, sausage, or sausage, egg, and cheese with a small McCafe coffee and hash browns for just $4 at McDonald's.
For the Quicken Loans or Rocket Arms, here's what the starting pitchers for the Cubs have done in this series. They have fared much better than the Pirates pitchers, who threw a ton of pitches in short starts.
Yeah, and the Pirates in the week leading into this series, 7 games prior to this series, were averaging close to 7 runs per game. They've had a very nice year offensively, hitting for a high average. They've been taking walks. They've been doing a lot of good things, but this Cubs pitching staff has pretty much shackled them.
Jordy Mercer. Reds bullpen gave up another run today. That's 22 consecutive games. They do have the lead, however, in the ninth.
Quickly becoming Joe Madden's favorite club.
Cub?
Club. Like a golfer. They have a favorite club, you know? They like to reach for. And
when in doubt.
Yeah, just there's a comfort factor there.
The Warren.
Yeah. And, you know, he's a hybrid because he can start and relieve.
Is that the Billy Baru? Or is that what it was called? From, Billy. From Caddyshack.
Hey.
One away. Here's McCutcheon.
Center fielder, Andrew McCutcheon.
And there's the little tip of the helmet.
The Billy Beru was the putter, right?
The Billy Beru? I'm going to go with yes.
Billy, Billy, Billy.
Deep right. Zobrist will play it off the wall. And McCutcheon has a stand-up double.
His home run was out to right center, base hit to right today, and now this double off the wall. McCutcheon talked about his power to all fields. Good-looking swing, man. It's only a matter of time before he starts to put up McCutcheon-like numbers. You know, they put pressure on today. They've had base runners in every inning except for the third. It'll be a frustrating day in that Pirate dugout as they've seen some chances come and go. Especially given that they've already lost the first two games of this series. You were asking earlier about the psychology. Are the Cubs in the Pirates' head? I think that, baseball is more, it's kind of a reactive game. Where do you go from here? How do you react if somebody comes into your own ballpark and sweeps you in a three-game set? You let it become an issue.
Right, and I think more than the fact that the Cubs are positioned to sweep here is you beat Gerrit Cole, who you beat in the wild card game. Arrieta was great again after that dominating performance. The Pirates have been a wild card team, not a division winner the last 3 years. That's been a narrative here, getting out of that one or done scenario. And the Cubs are very much in their way.
Yeah, and I think it's up to, to the hurdle, his staff, the veteran players. That's the key. How do you react if you're going through a tough patch? Just don't let it become an issue. Don't let the other team get into your head. Just go play.
And then you had the Monday night tension after the hit by pitch, although that has not carried over into these final two games of the series.
Good changeup.
Got four first names battling here. Adam Warren against Matt Joyce.
That's a sign of a good change. When you can locate it right there and get a swing and miss, I mean, that's for most guys, that you don't want to leave a changeup that high in the strike zone.
Fly ball to deep right, and Zobrist will have to watch it fly out of here. A two-run homer for Matt Joyce, who's been really good off their bench. Already his third pinch hit home run.
This time it's a fastball in a happy zone for him. 92 miles an hour. Up out over the plate. That's his power. That pull power. And the Pirates have two.
A three-run ball game and a strike on Marte.
Yeah. perfect world for Joe Maddon. Warren gets through this inning. Strope in the eighth, Rondon in the ninth. But just in case Strope is up throwing now.
Two balls, two strikes.
Well, sometimes you even miss hit it with your favorite club.
Change up, bounced foul. Change still 2-2
down and on the edges so far for Warren. Those runs he allowed, the first he has given up this year.
Zobrist does not have a play. Wind has kicked up a little bit, pushed that one to the seats, and gives Marte another opportunity. Two down. Hey, Cub fans, show your team pride with Cubs checking and an official Cubs MasterCard debit card, only available at your local Wintrust Community Bank. Go to wintrust.com/Cubs to learn more. Member FDIC. Cervelli turns away. To end the inning, two-run homer. Matt Joyce, and it's now 5-2 Cubs as we go to the eighth.
I forgot to record that show.
Now we have to wait forever to see it.
With DirecTV, you don't.
You see, we got the power to turn back time. That show you missed, let's just go back and find. And let's go back and choose spicy instead of mild. And maybe reconsider having that second child. See, that's the power to turn back time.
Watch shows you forgot to record. Call 1-800-DIRECTV.
Now it's in the hands of the bullpen, and out comes Papa John.
It looks like he's taking this official pizza thing pretty seriously.
For just $6.99 each, get two medium, two topping pizzas.
Papa John's, the official pizza of Major League Baseball.
I have a list.
Okay.
So, she needs automatic emergency braking, blind spot detection, and lane departure warning.
All available on the Elantra and Sonata.
And a better warranty than Toyota, Nissan, or Chevy.
America's best warranty, standard with every Hyundai.
Let's check in with the boss.
Okay. Sorry, excuse me.
We'll take both.
Hurry in and lease the 2017 Elantra for just $144 a month.
Just one.
Two.
She seems like a great boss.
Taking the hassle out of yard work just got even easier. During the Echo National Sales Event, get a pro-grade Echo trimmer or handheld blower for only $149.99 each, backed by a 5-year warranty. But hurry, these deals will be gone before you know it. So take back your yard with Echo.
Time for the hefty home run. Ben Zobrist giving the Cubs the lead with a 3-run shot. And then Anthony Rizzo adding some insurance in the 7th. There's Tony Watson, his first and only appearance in this series.
Normally, he's a guy Clint Hurdle relies on to come in the 8th inning, protect the lead, hand the ball to Mark Melancon, but they haven't had that opportunity. And Watson has been out there for 12 times. He's got a 3.55 ERA. He's a good one. Throws hard, good sinker, slider and a change.
Ross will start it. Looks like Ryan Kalish is on deck.
Watson gets a lot of work. 77 appearances last year, 78 the year before. Subbed 2 ERAs both those seasons.
Remember, Watson was the guy who hit Arrieta in the wild card game in the 7th inning, and tempers flared. Two and oh.
Shift on the infield for Ross, straight up in the outfield. Could very well be hacking here, 3-0. Nope.
Takes it. Cassio, Hughes, Vogelsong, and now Watson. And he walked him. Fifth walk taken by the Cubs. Here's Kalish. Get back to the big leagues last night. See, off to a great start at AAA Iowa. Previously 57 games in 2014 with the Cubs. He's been on the even year plan 2010, 2012, 2014, 2016 with Boston and the Cubs. And he bunts toward first. Jaso to Harrison for the out. Sacrifice for Kalish.
Beautifully done. Hey, Clark's Crew is the official kids club of the Chicago Cubs. Team up with Clark as a member of Clark's Crew and receive kids specific perks, experiences and merchandise. Visit cubs.com/kids to sign up your young Cubs so they can be part of the fun all season long.
So Ryan Kalish, do you have to borrow a Zany suit since he got here yesterday?
I think he's probably gotten an exemption from having to wear a Zany suit. But I'd give him high marks if he went out and found one.
Bounce foul. Thank you. got some funky socks that you usually wear. Maybe you can just give him those.
Give up some socks. Fowler with a 474 on base percentage. Been on twice today. Single and a walk, first two trips.
Just to give you an idea, it's still so early. His career high in terms of on-base percentage, 389. That was 2012. So, you know, I don't think he's going to finish the year in the upper fours, but his pace has been very impressive.
League average is 325 on base percentage.
He has hit 300 once. That was 2012 when he hit 300 with the Rockies. Ground ball to short. Mercer to Jaso. And it's Jorge Soler for La Stella. Guessing we'll see Kayla stay in the game for defense. And maybe Zobrist goes to second.
In, yeah.
You're into the whole, you know, predict the answer before we give it. Mm-hmm. Do a run predictor. And that's some other things we've done. I've been trying to guess Joe Maddon's lineups. That's fun on a daily basis. I got everything right today. The actual batting order. The only thing I got wrong, I had Baez at second and La Stella at third.
Well, you won't make that mistake again.
No, I won't. Well, I might.
Do you do that over morning coffee? Debate the lineup?
Yes, I do. I actually do it for both teams. I had Chris Stewart starting for the Pirates, but Clint Hurdle went with Cervelli.
You could do a whole contest. You could do an online thing, like guess the lineup with Len, and people could try to beat you to try to guess along with you.
It's not a
Make suggestions.
Idea.
You can say, hey, Len, do you realize that Tommy La Stella is batting 427 against fastballs this year? This is the guy in the mound is going to throw a lot of fastballs today. You might want to think about Tommy.
I'm more of a Quadrophenia guy. Oh, you're talking La Stella. Okay. Reading the Pete Townsend book. Backhanded Mercer. And Jaso stayed on the bag, and that will end the inning. 5-2 Cubs as we go to the bottom of the eighth from Pittsburgh.
Meet the product development experts at Turtle Wax. They invented Dash and Glass. Consumers voted it 2016 Product of the Year. They made it so people don't have to worry about getting dash cleaner on the glass or glass cleaner on the dash, because Turtle Wax Dash and Glass cleans both. Turtle Wax. Trusted innovation inside and out.
Wendy's Jalapeno Fresco Spicy Chicken with fresh jalapenos and ghost pepper sauce. Some said
it's too spicy,
but Wendy's launched it anyway and doubled down with ghost pepper fries. So if you're hot for spice, then these are for you.
And here we go, folks.
It's your favorite hot dog bun, mustard, and overpriced watered-down beer.
Are you sure you want to eat all that? Because you already weigh more than your team's batting average.
Let's just toast to our anniversary.
Oh, no, it's corked.
Let's just watch the game. I tweeted all of your friends to come over, but I guess no one showed up. just like at Mobile Phone Park.
That's okay. I invited one of your friends, too.
There's a long drive, and it's out of here.
Give a real anniversary gift this year. Escape to the Champagne Lodge in Willowbrook, just 25 minutes southwest of Chicago.
It's a whole new ball game with MLB Extra Innings on DirecTV.
It is magic.
Experience the ultimate season ticket, now at a new, lower price.
Unbelievable.
Every punch out.
He got him.
Every rundown.
What a play.
And every walk-off.
Whoa.
All at your fingertips.
What a catch.
And with MLB.tv included, you can watch nearly 100 live games a week on over 400 supported devices. Don't miss a minute of the action. Follow your favorite team on any screen with MLB Extra Innings on DirecTV. Order now.
Cubs Nationals, tomorrow at 7 on CSN.
I'm Kelly Crawl in our Comcast Sportsnet studios with this Sportsnet Central update. Don't forget, after the final out, be sure and stick around as Todd Hollingsworth joins me to break it all down on Cubs Postgame Live. Then tonight at 5:30, Catman is in the house with Sports Talk Live, followed by Sportsnet Central at 6:30 as they get you ready for the White Sox and Red Sox. Cubs in front 5-2. Let's send it back to Lynn and JD in Pittsburgh, guys.
Kelly, thanks. Well, as we mentioned, Kalish staying in. He plays right. That'll move Zobrist closer to home plate. Right to second. Pedro Strop looking for a hold. He's got a three-run lead. Trying to get the ball to Hector Rondon without any drama.
Good stuff from Strope so far this year with a 2.61 ERA, 14 strikeouts, 3 walks, and 10 and a third. Adam Warren, an inning and a third today, 2 hits, 2 runs, no walks, a strikeout. Rodriguez singled and then was picked off by David Ross back in the second.
Rodriguez staring okay, down
yeah,
Strope.
Yeah, Strope staring right back. Jeff Nelson yelling out, let's go. Doesn't want any drama.
Yeah, he's talking to the Cubs dugout.
Whatever you want, Rodriguez just said. He's ready for a little fisticuffs.
Good on Jeff Nelson.
Jeff Nelson, you get control of yourself or you're gone. Last year, Rodriguez is right in the middle of it. You see he and David Ross tangling during the wild card game. And he went to town on the cooler.
Swing and a miss. Look at Rodriguez. Well, the thing is, if the batter's in the box, he's ready to hit. He should be ready to hit. And if the pitcher's job is to upset the hitter's timing, that's
sure,
what he's
yeah.
doing.
Yeah,
now, there are some guys who they don't like that quick pitch, but if the batter's ready to hit, why can't he vary his delivery? He doesn't have to stop in the set position with nobody on base. Now, you're a pitcher, so you're going to agree, but.
Of course not. It's within the rules. You absolutely can vary your delivery. I'm not sure if that's exactly what Rodriguez is taking umbrage with. You know, he may have not liked the way Strope reacted. You know, he took a big swing. I don't know.
Kalish for out number 2. Go. strike. Here's the pitch.
He's kind of staring out. Pedro's looking back at him. Nelson's like, that's enough. Let's just play ball. Are you looking at me?
Base hit.
And normally when Strope uses that quick pitch, he gets a lot of swings. Guys get a little jumpy. That time he used the quick pitch. Pitch was up and Polanco able to put a good swing on it. I'm surprised more guys don't do it, especially guys whose stuff is a little short.
Can't do it with a runner on base, or it'll be a balk as he'll take it unassisted to end the inning as he retires Jason. Little stare down in the eighth. Strope does not allow a run, and we go to the ninth, 5-2.
Hey, Chicago, when did paying for airfare become so unfair? At Southwest, we believe in transparency. Transparency means we don't dream up ways we can trick you into paying more. It's why we still let two bags fly free and don't have change fees. So our low fares stay low. Just the way you like it.
I need something that can keep up with all my adventures.
Well, the RAV4 has available sport-tuned suspension.
I like the sound of that.
And great handling, so it can do just about anything.
Thanks, Jan. This is exactly what I'm looking for.
I know.
Do you?
Yep.
Right now, during Toyota time, get 0% APR financing for 60 months on a new 2016 RAV4. Hurry in today.
Here are your keys.
Thanks.
See you out there.
Sweet.
Toyota, let's go places.
Get ready for an exciting Cubs finish. Brought to you by New Finish Car Polish and the number one rated scratch remover, Scratch Doctor.
Welcome back. How do you get to Wrigley Field? The Cubs suggest taking public transportation. The Cubs do offer a free bike check and is now located by the Addison Red Line station. For drivers, the Cubs provide free remote parking and shuttle service on night and weekend games. For information, visit the A to Z guide at Cubs.com. Melanson has turned into one of the more dependable closers in the game. For the Pirates this year, he's appeared 12 times. It's a 2.61 ERA. Pirates are off tomorrow, so chance to get him a little work. Our first look at him in this series.
I'm smelling rain. I don't see it. Skies have darkened a little bit. We play the ninth inning here in Pittsburgh, 5-2 Cubs.
Cut fastball, the calling card of Mark Melanson. He's so effective against left-handed hitters with that pitch. Runs the ball in on their hands, has a good overhand curveball.
Yeah. tucked in to left. Chris Bryant keeps his hitting streak intact. It's a 10.
And we've seen Joe do it against Melanson. He'll keep his right-handed bats in there as opposed to pinch hit late in the game against him in a tight game where they're trailing, just because of his ability to get in on the knuckles of the left-handed hitters. Tried to sneak the fastball in on Bryant there, and he was quick enough to get to it. What a series Rizzo has had.
A line shot foul to right. He could have three hits today. Right now he has two. Double and a homer.
Six out of 13 in the series so far, four doubles and a home run.
Melanson is 31 years old. Former Yankee, Astro, Red Sox. Two times now with the Pirates, he's been an all-star in his first three seasons here.
Remember when he went to the Red Sox and they used him, tried him as a closer, and he really struggled. And I remember, you know, reading things at the time. Well, he just doesn't have the makeup. So much for that.
Batting it up in two or three different pieces, and the Cubs have something cooking. First and third, nobody out. On base again, his third consecutive hit.
I hope he wasn't growing really fond of that bat. He's done a lot of good work with it lately, but it dies a hero at least. Flutters that one into shallow left. Calcio broke two or three bats today. I don't know how many bats guys bring with them on it for a three-game series. Probably more than they need.
Biggest hit of this game was the Zobrist three-run homer in the third. Put the Cubs on top. He pops this one up, and the runners are probably going to hold. In fact, Bryant's not even tagging. He went halfway down the line as Harrison makes the catch.
Follow Cubs baseball live with the MLB.com at Bat app. Stay up to the moment at any moment with Game Day. Live game video highlights, Statcast news, and more. Download MLB.com at Bat, the number one app for live baseball on your phone and tablet. I think most of the school kids have boarded the buses and headed home.
28,782.
These guys are hanging in there. They're not front runners.
Well, they've got their backpacks ready. Baez the batter. Pirates at double play depth. Inside. Come on,
Cubs now with 12 hits on the afternoon. The Pirates have 11. Baez with three of those hits here this afternoon.
Rizzo fake towards second. Baez waited till the last second to try to bunt. Don't know if that was called for or not.
Not a bad play. The Cubs like to use that safety squeeze in this situation. First and third and one out.
Harrison leaves his feet. They get one. That's it. Baez will get an RBI and a fielder's choice. 6-2.
Second RBI of the day for Baez. Had one in the ball game yesterday. Looked like he was really concentrating and trying to keep the hands pulled in. Stroke. Kind of a passive approach. Well, there they go. And maybe they were just working on their floating there for a while.
That will take away a save opportunity from Rondon. Polanco makes the catch. Cubs had a run to their lead at 6-2. Three outs to go as they shoot for the sweep.
They treat you like you're their best friend or your family. It's almost like they can't do enough for you.
Hello, I'm Dan Fields of the Fields Auto Group. We simply treat people the way we want to be treated.
I get a personal treatment here, and I recommend it.
It includes our free loaners, free car washes, and cafes. It's all part of the Fields Matters program.
I'm looking for the best price, and Fields gives you that. That's why we've bought so many cars from them.
Fields matters because you matter.
FieldsAuto.com.
I forgot to record that show.
Now we have to wait forever to see it.
With DirecTV, you don't.
You see, we got the power to turn back time. That show you missed, let's just go back and find. And let's go back and choose spicy instead of mild. And maybe reconsider having that second child. See, that's the power to turn back time.
Watch shows you forgot to record. Call 1-800-DIRECTV.
For the last 5 days, 17 hours, and 23 minutes, you've been a passenger.
I'm back in baby's arms. How I miss those.
The Mazda 6 with SkyActiv technology makes it good to be a driver.
Benny's toast of the game. It is presented by Benny's Beverage Depot, and we're going to give it to the starter, John Lester. Resourceful, and he worked out of a couple of big jams.
And for the second start in a row, he worked out of a bases loaded, nobody out jam without allowing a run. So 5 2/3 today. 8 hits, a couple of walks, but no runs. 5 strikeouts. He's lowered his ERA to 1.58.
Benny's Beverage Depot is the official champagne provider of the Chicago Cubs.
No save opportunity for Rondon. He works for the ninth time.
That's these guys.
A little dispirited there.
A good time all the time. Hector Rondon with a fastball in for a strike on Jordy Mercer. Cubs trying to get to 20 wins. White Sox can do that tonight. They're hosting Boston. Cubs trying to be the first team, though, to get to 20.
Rondon very aggressive, attacks with that fastball. We got the loss last time out, the extra inning game against the Braves at the end of the homestand.
Kalish circling, he's got it. Tomorrow night, the National League's top teams will square off at Wrigley Field. Bryce Harper and the Nationals against Chris Bryant and the Cubs. These guys were childhood friends back in Las Vegas. Cubs and Nationals. All starts at 7 on CSN Chicago.
Kyle Hendricks will pitch for the Cubs. Young Joe Ross for the Nationals. Man, has he ever been good? He's got an 0.79 ERA.
And rests the bat on his back shoulder as he gets ready to hit. Swing and a miss. 2-1. Slider.
Man, that was pretty impressive. A couple fastballs up and then back down with the slider. Rondon has added a changeup he's mixing in on occasion this year.
Here's Chris Stewart. Pinch hitting. The 1-1 to right and out of play. Mets shut out the Braves 8-0. Reds beat the Giants 7-4. Those are your finals. Brewers lead the Angels 3-2 in the seventh in Milwaukee. Nationals running away from the Royals in a rubber game 11-2 in the fifth. Early on, scoreless. Mariners at Oakland, Rockies at Padres.
There's a bit of a Revolutionary War ring to it, doesn't it? The Nationals against the Royals.
Yeah, it does.
Rondon trying to figure out how he wants to end this ball game. A little front door slider just missed. He's thrown strike one almost 80% of the time this year. Small sample, but it's a huge uptick from last year.
The 3-2, a fly ball right center, Fowler tracking. Kalish in front of him makes the grab. Ball game over. Cubs win. Cubs sweep. 6-2 the final today. And JD, this was the closest of the three games.
Yeah, there were a couple moments in this game where the Pirates, had they gotten a big hit, would have put a lot of extra pressure on the Cubs bullpen. They were not able to do it. Lester, resilient, tough when he needed to be, dealt with some traffic, but ended up posting a zero through 5 2/3, and just a very impressive three-game sweep by the Cubs, holding down this Pirate club. As I mentioned the previous week, they were averaging about 7 runs per game, and they got what, 5 total in this series.
So they'll head home to take on the NL East leading Washington Nationals, who appear on their way to their 19th win. Cubs are 20-6, and we'll have the opener of the 4-game set right here on CSN Chicago at 7 o'clock Central Time. For JD and our entire crew here in Pittsburgh, Len Casper with your final. Cubs 6, Pirates 2. Stay tuned. We'll have Blue Cross Blue Shield Cubs post game live from our downtown Chicago studios next.
Finish off the series sweep against the Pirates behind another terrific outing from John Lester. And the bats stay hot at PNC. Joe Maddon's club picks up their 20th win of the season, 6-2. A little drama once again, John.
A little bit of drama, but just an incredibly intense approach by the offense. It was really fun to watch at the beginning of this ball game, putting together quality bats, giving themselves opportunities, letting John settle into the ball game, get him that lead, makes that lead stand up, turn it over to the bullpen. We've talked about a formula. They've been able to stick to the script all season long. 20th win of the season.
They keep ace in the test. Well, Holly and I will be back in just a moment to break down Lester's outing, talk some offense, and get you set for the upcoming series against the Nationals. A happy flight for Joe and company. And Cubs Post Game Live is on the way here on Comcast Sportsnet.
T-Mobile is going big for small business. You'll never get charged data overages, ever. Get your own 24/7 dedicated business account team. And with double the LTE coverage in the last year, you can get more done in more places. Right now, get 2 lines with 6 gigs each for just $80. And for a limited time, get a hotspot free. Yeah, free. Switch your business to T-Mobile at work today.
Thanks, man.
Imagine if the things you bought every day earned you miles to get to the places you really want to go. With the United Mileage Plus Explorer Card, you get a free checked bag, 2 United Club Passes, priority boarding, and 30,000 bonus miles. Everything you need for an unforgettable vacation. The United Mileage Plus Explorer Card. Imagine where it'll take you.
Not us.
Nah, no reruns here.
Yeah, we have X1 from Xfinity.
Everybody crochet tonight.
I think we'll just stick with our TV shows.
Don't fall for DirecTV. Get 4 times more TV shows and movies on demand with Xfinity. Sign up today or get started with this great offer. Call or go online today.
Cubs baseball on CSN Chicago is brought to you in part by Southwest Airlines. Transparency, low fares, nothing to hide. Your Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana Honda dealers, as reliable as the cars themselves. Xfinity. Xfinity X1 will change the way you experience TV. Audi. Truth in engineering. Menards. Save big money at Menards. And by Toyota. Discover more in a Toyota. Visit buyatoyota.com or your local Toyota dealer today. Let's go places. This is Cubs Post Game Live. Presented by Blue Cross Blue Shield of Illinois.
The 3-2, a fly ball right center, Fowler tracking, Kalish in front of him makes the grab, ball game over, Cubs win, Cubs sweep.
That's right, the Cubs pull out the brooms in the Steel City. Six more runs to bring the Northsiders' ridiculous run differential up to 93 now against opponents this season. Madden's club outscored Pittsburgh 19-5 in this series. 12 hits on the day, as you see here, and the boys in blue are feeling good as they head back to the Windy City this evening. Hello and welcome everyone to Cubs Post Game Live, presented by Blue Cross Blue Shield, along with Todd Hollinsworth. I'm Kelly Kroll. Another W for Joe Madden's club as they complete the series sweep against the Pirates. It's number 20 already in the young season for the Cubs. And considering Pittsburgh was supposed to be the team, Todd, in the division that was going to push them, what kind of statement is this from Joe Madden's club?
It's a statement, but I wouldn't get too crazy with this. This is a long season. It's the beginning of May. I don't think anybody needs to get too off a line here. The Cubs are playing great baseball. That's what you acknowledge. Certainly it's a bit of a statement. You want to go in and you beat Pirates. You want to go in and beat the Cardinals, and you come out and you set a statement again today. It's getaway day. These aren't the easiest games to play, especially for the team that's flying, and I really felt like they came out and set the tone early, didn't get away from their game, put the quality at bats out there, got the pitch up against Nicasio, and again, the same script that we watched throughout this entire series, continue to get guys on base. And again, it wasn't, you know, we're talking 6-for-10s coming through with runners in scoring position. It's coming up with 15 opportunities and coming through 3 or 4 times. So you saw it again today. John Lester, outstanding, works himself out of a bases loaded jam, nobody out jam again. That's 2 starts in a row. Outstanding effort there. Boy, he continues to get that done. It's the equation for winning, and they get that early lead, you turn it over to the pitching, and you let your bullpen do its job.
It was fun to watch, even John Lester in those moments. Fun to watch, although we don't want to see too many. But the Cubs, like Holly just said, making Juan Nicasio work from the very first inning, nearly 30 pitches in that opening frame, eventually get to him in the third. Let's take a look at how this one unfolded. Top three is where we will start. 2 outs here for Anthony Rizzo. And a hard line drive to center field right there. They count this as an error on Andrew McCutchen.
Absolutely
you can't
ridiculous.
Believe it, can you?
Yeah, that's a tough call. You know, and it's kind of one of those where they went for it. And the pitch after this, by the way, is the one that's going to get the positive. We'll get the highlight in a second. But this is absolutely ridiculous. Anthony scalds this ball. McCutchen gets a break, dives for it, tries to make a spectacular catch. He's not able to secure the catch. And here you go. Next pitch. There you go. It happens all the time. You see in the game of baseball some momentum swing right there. Big response by Ben Zobrist right there, jumping on that first pitch fastball, taking full advantage of the error slash double. I'm going to give him a double for it, 4-for-5.
Why
there
not?
You go, Anthony. Not that it counts, but it should have been a hit. But Ben Zobrist does his thing, gets a pitch to crush right there. Had a real nice first at bat. Thought he just missed one to right. Gets a little bit better pitch there and makes him pay.
And then here in the fourth, this is Cervelli. The single loads the bases. And then, as you were talking about earlier, John Lester at this point with no out, bases juiced, and he manages to get himself out of it after, of course, a little meeting there from Chris Bassio.
Now, he seems to be at his best with runners in scoring position. Now, I'll throw a little nugget out here for people. I find it very interesting. I'm not trying to create conversation, but he actually is more relaxed in these situations than he is with just a runner on first base. And we talk about the threat of the stolen base. In this situation, going back to last week, runners in scoring position against John Lester on the season, 143 batting average against. That's amazing. That's a guy who's dialed in, who knows how to make pitches against the heart of the lineup, the bottom of the lineup, execute pitches, and even get that bad contact that you need to have. And you saw it right there. Nothing was going to get those runs in with the 2 strikeouts and the short fly ball to right field. At the same time, I think it's worth noting he struggles with just a runner on first base, and it kind of explains the situation and a little bit of what John's been dealing with throughout his career. So get those runners on base. He's not afraid to pitch in those situations and get himself out of it. We saw it a game ago. We saw it again today. He, a lot of times, is at his best.
A clutch pitcher in those moments, buckling down. Well, certainly at that point, Cubs up 3-0, and John Lester keeps it that way. We move to the 7th inning. Anthony Rizzo able to tack on one right here. He was swinging the bat well, continues to do that, Todd.
Yeah, gets a little bit more lift. We talked about how much throughout the series he's been squaring up and hitting line drives. Gets a little spinner, a little backup slider right there. Gets great extension and actually gets the ball up just enough to get it out. Great swing right there. He's got that room on the barrel that a lot of hitters don't have. So again, you're seeing Anthony Rizzo in a hot zone right now. He and Chris Bryant, and I've talked about this an awful lot, as well as his team has played, there's still hitters in this lineup that really want to start to get going. I think we saw in this series Bryant start to really get it done consistently. You're seeing Anthony. We saw the power. We've seen it all season long, but the quality of the at-bat is really starting to develop. You're seeing it the first game of this series all the way through, has the double, has the base hit, chokes up, makes a great adjustment against Melanson, who throws the cutter and gets the broken bat base hit. So Anthony is in a really, really good spot right now. I expect things going into this national series, which is going to be a big one.
Yes, it will. Five extra base hits for Rizzo in this series. Could have been more, as Todd mentioned earlier, of course, the error. And then in the eighth, things get a little feisty here. We've seen this from Rodriguez a time or two, kind of his MO, but starts to bark a little bit at Pedro Strop, who gets back at him. Then the benches, he's talking to the bench here, and we've seen this before, Todd, but does it make things interesting, heat up the series at all when you see this kind of stuff? Or
I think there's separation. I mean, there's one common denominator here, and it's Sean Rodriguez. That's just it. You have to leave it at that, and I think even the Pirates wanted no part of what was kind of going on in that situation. Pedro Strop did nothing wrong. All he does, and I noticed this the other night, which is something he's developed. I don't know how long he's been doing it, but I kind of have picked up on it. When there's nobody on base, he'll come set with the first pitch, deliver it. If he gets ahead, he'll roll through the second one, and he's allowed to do that. Doesn't have to stop. He's not holding anybody on base, but it's a bit of a quick pitch, and sometimes hitters will react to that. But again, he's not doing anything wrong. He's certainly not breaking the rules. Sean Rodriguez, I'm not going to make him the representative of the Pirates. I don't think that they would say it that way, but we do know that he has got a short fuse and has the propensity to explode at times. We saw what he did to the Gatorade cooler last year. So, I mean, consider the source. I mean, I'll just leave it at that. I don't think anything comes of it, though.
Sure, and Pedro Strop did get the last laugh in that anyway with the strikeout. Let's move on to our Elk Grove pitching recap. And what a series it was for Cubs starters. John Lester following suit, doing his part this afternoon. A look at his line and Juan Nicasio. Exactly as you stated before the game, Holly, Cubs' patience pays off. They get his pitch count up, able to capitalize in the third, and some insurance later, as we just saw.
Well, it's relentless going up against Juan Nicasio or anybody else that it's been. It really has been the story for the Cubs all season long. I mean, we look at the line, 4 1/3. It was just like last night with Nice, the night before that with Cole. Again, recognize that it's the offense, not the guys that they're going up against. It has been a relentless, long, kind of drawn-out games. We talk about all the time these games are so long, but it's the quality of the at-bats. These guys don't give things away. John Lester, outstanding performance today. I think he had to work a little bit harder than maybe he thought, but again, I also thought that the Pirates were going to try to play their best game of the series today. I talked about, I know it's getaway day, but they really wanted to get a win out of this. They weren't going to go up there swinging early, trying to make things happen. I thought they might put a little bit more pressure on him on the mound, and we talked about that in one of the keys of the game. But they weren't able to get that done because after the Zobrist homer, as I've always said, you're playing from behind. So, again, you're not out there trying to steal bases all the time when you're chasing three. So, I mean, it really came down to that. Worked the outside corner all day long, John Lester. Bottom line is this. I love when he attacks the low part of the zone. Kept these hitters off balance. Not a lot of bad contact. Couple spots where he gave up a few hits in a row, and I thought maybe he got a little tired there at the very end, but a solid, solid performance. 103 pitches, 5 2/3 innings.
Third win of the season, absolutely. Well, overall in this series, I mentioned it earlier, what a solid outing from these three gentlemen right here. Jason Hamill, Jake Arrieta, John Lester, 17 2/3 innings pitched, gave up just 2 runs. No, that can't be right, because they added one more. 3 runs this entire series, Todd. I mean, regardless of the math, that's right. My math, that is. That's an incredible
It's impressive. There's no doubt about it. I mean, they're in a zone right now. And again, you know, part of it is how I talk about how this team has worked and kind of bringing it all together. You know, think about it in terms of this. You know, we talk about how many pitches the Cubs hitters are seeing. So every time that your pitcher goes out there, and even that pressure-filled inning that John was in, he gets a break because the at-bats that the Cubs are putting out there are long and they're lengthy and they're seeing 20-plus pitches an inning. So, you know, you get a glass of water, you're not back out there in 5 or 6 pitches. It's just set itself up very nicely for our staff, and our staff has not been pressured in that, you know, they're racing in, getting themselves in some trouble, coming back to the dugout, watching a first pitch swing here, or, you know, a couple, 2-3 outs. Next thing you know, 7 pitches later, you're back out on the mound. They've done a fantastic job even controlling the pace of the game of baseball, and that's the one thing that really stands out to me. The pitching has been lights out. I mean, it's about pitch execution right now, and when you're pitching with the lead, which isn't always the easiest thing to do, they've maintained their game plans. That's always key. Don't get in there. It wasn't like even in this one when the lead was 4-0 and 5-0, that, you know, I'm just going to start grooving it. The guys were still executing pitches, going out there, trying to make pitches. The Pirates, they are a good team. I know we didn't make them look so good in this series, is what you wanted to see. But they are a very good team, and they're going to be reckoned with at some point again this season.
Well, I know you said that they would more than likely try to put some pressure on John Lester, and the throw to first base is what we've been waiting to see a little bit more from him. In the bottom of the second here, Francisco Cervelli, the comebacker to Lester, it gets stuck in his glove there, and he just, as we've seen him do actually before, tosses the entire mitt to Anthony Rizzo, still effective.
That's easy
in a way.
You know what, get the outs. That's the bottom line, and I think that's how John thinks. He doesn't really care what anybody else thinks and really doesn't, you know, what anybody else is going to say. The bottom line is this, he's controlling the situation, and that's really the most important thing to talk about here. Right. I mean, these things happen. I mean, the bottom line is whether the ball comes out of the glove or not, part of me actually thinks he might be happy that the ball's stuck in the glove so he can toss the glove and run it over there and not have to worry about actually throwing it. But again, until we get ourselves into a situation where it becomes an issue and somebody exposes this to a bigger, a greater degree than what we've seen, I mean, again, the beat moves on. I mean, he goes out there and gets another win today, pitches outstanding, gets the lead and makes it stand up. And I'll bring back one other point. Remember in this game that David Ross picked off a runner at first base. And in that situation, you almost had the sense, and I can't remember who it was at the time, but he was getting a bigger and bigger lead. Matter of fact, I think it was Sean Rodriguez was getting a bigger and bigger lead, but it was a secondary lead. It was like, if you're going to test him and you're going to push him and dare him to throw to first, you're going to have to go at some point. It was the third or fourth pitch of the at-bat. You've now got a huge secondary lead, and you can't even get back to back. Anthony actually tags him twice before he even gets close enough to the bag because he got such a huge secondary lead. But that's not doing anything to John Lester. That's actually giving David Ross an opportunity to throw you out.
Yeah, no question. Looking like he's in his prime there behind the plate, of course, with that out. Well, we're going to take our first time out here on Cubs Post Game Live presented by Blue Cross Blue Shield. We will be right back.
Cubs Post Game Live is presented by Blue Cross Blue Shield of Illinois. Through it all.
Something doesn't feel right.
Green lights across the board. What's going on up there?
No backup system. Houston, I'm flying solo here.
Does he have it?
I'm on it. Re-entry in 3, 2, 1.
Thanks for the care package, Houston. Dinner's on me. Just another day in the rocket biz. Oh, fudge nuggets.
This is how precision listens. Bose microphones that hear engine noise, then counter it with the sound-canceling frequency, which helps make the cabin so quiet, you don't miss a thing.
Night, Dad.
Good night, kiddo.
It's called active noise cancellation, and it's available in the new, meticulously crafted 2016 Sierra from GMC. This is the precision of professional grade. Now get 15% below MSRP on select GMC Sierra 1500 models in stock. That's nearly 9,000 on this GMC Sierra Denali.
We are the Coors Brewing Company, and our mountain is brewing the world's most refreshing beer. A beer proud enough to wear our name in big, red, scripted letters. That's why we lager, filter, and package cold. Because we believe every climb deserves a refreshing finish. Whatever your mountain, climb on.
Now playing on DirecTV Cinema.
Your partner is marrying your sister.
It's busy.
You say that again, I'm gonna shoot you in the face.
You got a new assignment. We're sending you to Miami.
I'm taking the lead.
Because we're not ready.
I'm ready, man.
Okay.
Let's get ridiculous!
How do we get in undetected?
Prince Admiral Stephen Matumbe.
Plus my two servants.
I'm not your servant.
You are what I say!
Ride Along 2 with a hilarious gag reel. Now playing on DirecTV Cinema. Movies start at channel 125.
You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you.
Call Adolescent Growth today and see how our proven treatment programs for eating disorders can begin to bring the sunshine back in the life of your teen and your family.
Please don't take my sunshine away.
Welcome back. Time now for our Four Seasons heating, air conditioning, plumbing. Who's hot and who's not? In the last 7 days for the Nationals, entering this afternoon's game against the Royals, Daniel Murphy, 9-for-27, 3 runs, 3 doubles, and 5 RBI. Who's not Jonathan Papelbon? Just 3 2/3 innings, gave up 7 hits and 3 earned runs. We will see them very soon. While our UPS store taking care of business, player of the game, Anthony Rizzo is who we're going with. 3-for-5 this afternoon with 3 runs. And Todd, it was one heck of a series for Mr. Rizzo.
Absolutely. 7-for-14, 500 batting average came into the series. And again, that's really the only thing that stands out. I know we're just used to talking numbers here, and batting average really doesn't matter in today's day. Sabermetrics and everything. Came in hitting 220. He's now up to 260. It's an impressive little run. It's good to see. And as the temperatures start to rise here in Chicago, that push. I mean, again, the power's been there. The RBIs have been there. The quality of the at-bats have been there. The batting average is just kind of the one thing that was dragging a little bit. And you're watching him start to climb. That's actually one of my favorite at-bats right there today. And I know it looks like the least of the damage that he did. But it was the approach against Melanson, who throws the cutter. It's understanding that. As good as he's been in, he chokes up right there at the beginning of the at-bat and finds something that he can handle and is able to dump it in the left field. It was actually a really, really big at-bat for him right there as he gets his third hit and kind of gets a little bit of a rally going to respond to the Pirates' two-run homer.
Feeling more and more comfortable at the plate here in May, we welcome you back into Cubs Postgame Live, of course, presented by Blue Cross Blue Shield. We'll head on into our Honda winning box score and take a look at some of what the other guys did this afternoon up and down the lineup. Look at those numbers. I know you just said it's not about the numbers, but I mean, these guys are producing, and Rizzo there in the middle, 3-for-5, but all the way down to Baez. Another a big day for him at the plate following what was an 0-for-5 day yesterday. That has to be good for him.
Solid at-bats all the way through. Yeah, 3 hits for Baez. Obviously, Anthony had the big day. Chris Bryant extends his hitting streak. Everybody did something that adds to something. And even David Ross in the 8th spot in the lineup, 0-for-2 with a couple walks. Long, lengthy at-bat, takes a 3-2 pitch, gets a big walk. You don't realize what it does to the top of the lineup as it works its way back around. You've got guys on base, you're constantly putting pressure on the mound. That's just it. The victories lie not always in going, 2-for-4, 3-for-5 in a ball game. Individually, you love it. You feel good about yourself. But when you watch how this team works, it's the combination of all of these, the 0-for-3s with the 2 walks and the runs scored that lead to what the story has become with this Cubs team and that run differential and, averaging 6+ runs a ball game.
Yeah, and Chris Bryant extended his streak. Todd mentioned just all around another great day at the plate, top to bottom for the Cubs. And we are going to take one more time out here. And when we return on Cubs Post Game Live, presented by Blue Cross Blue Shield, we'll take a look back at Holly's keys to the game and preview this weekend's series against Dusty Baker, Bryce Harper, and the Nationals.
For small business owners, there's never enough time in the day. Carly goes from cooking for 3 people to catering for 300. Basically, we're her back office. Whether it's having flyers available at her venues, banners, posters, we'll be here to help tell her story. And she knows that. Carly knows that.
From printing to packing, shipping to marketing, together, there's nothing we can't solve. Go to a UPS store today to see how.
Hate shopping for a used car because you feel like you might be buying someone else's problem? Well, with a Continental Certified car, you don't have to worry. Just look for this.
Buy with confidence knowing that the car has been through an 80-point quality and safety inspection. Comes with a 30-day, 1,000-mile warranty. And get this, a 3-day exchange policy.
So check out our huge selection of Continental Certified cars only at Continental Motors. 10 brands, 8 locations, thousands of choices. Only at Continental Motors and ContinentalMotors.com.
Yeah, Xfinity built this newer thingy that lets me search with my voice.
We're good.
Don't fall for DirecTV. Find shows faster with the X1 voice remote, only from Xfinity. Sign up today or get started with this great offer. Call or go online today.
This program on Comcast SportsNet is brought to you by ATI Physical Therapy, taking physical therapy to a higher level. Ask your doctor about ATI Physical Therapy.
Create the perfect outdoor living space for your home with landscape blocks from Menards. 16-inch brick-faced patio blocks available in 3 colors are only $2.49 each. Protect, preserve, and stain like a pro with Cabot Exterior Wood Care Products. Cabot offers unbeatable quality and satisfaction guaranteed. Great for decks, fences, docks, furniture, and more. Save $7 a gallon. That's $35 on 5-gallon pails. Get more colors and satisfaction guaranteed with Cabot from Menards.
Save big money.
money at Menards.
E-Click Lending, Chicagoland's mortgage price leader. Never pay lender fees. Never pay upfront appraisal fees. Get approved online, anytime, anywhere, in less than 10 minutes on our 100% digital platform. Go to eClickLending.net to see how low your rate could go. E-Click Lending. Point, click, save.
Sportsnet Central, every night at 6:30, 10, 10:30, and midnight.
Cubs fans, be sure and show your team pride with Cubs checking and an official Cubs MasterCard debit card only available at your local Wintrust Community Bank. Go to wintrust.com/cubs to learn more. Member FDIC. Well, we had our man, Chris Kamka, do some number crunching, and here's what he came up with today. Best run differential through the first 26 games since 1900. Only two teams were better than what the Cubs are doing right now, plus 93. That would be the 1905 Giants and 1902 Pirates. We are seeing something special right now, Todd, with this Cubs team, as though we haven't already said that, but to see it here, you see the historical.
I'm gonna defer to Joe Maddon just one day at a time here. I know it's fun to talk about, certainly fun to look at. I mean, these numbers are extraordinary, but again, Joe has got these guys focused. Today was a classic, maybe give it away game, you know, where the pace or the tempo could have been a little bit different. They were outstanding.
All right, Todd, well, let's revisit your keys from the pregame show sponsored by Blue Cross Blue Shield.
All right, Lita, well, we did pretty good today. The Cubs have been making me look good all year. I love it. Leadoff man, Cubs, not just Dexter Fowler. The one thing that we know in this series is that the Cubs put that lead runner on constantly in this series. Today you saw it as well. 3 out of 4 in those first four innings. 4 out of 4 yesterday. 4 out of 4 the day before that. 11 in the first four innings of all three games in the series. 11 of 12 leadoff men were getting on base. That's just talking about putting pressure. Eventually you're going to score. We've talked about it in so many ways. Ben Zobrist comes up with a big hit. 60 feet, 6 inches. Well, now, I thought that the Pirates, and I'm telling you, I'm going to nail this one of these times. We're going to get a few people that are going to bunt on them a few times. There were a few comebackers, and we saw a little bit of action, but John was able to get it done. I mean, that's really what the bottom line is getting that out of first base. It didn't become an issue. I really do expect at some point he's going to deal with some bunts. And last one is getaway day. And, they got the sweep, so nothing more to add to that.
And now they come back home, start a four-game set with the Nationals. First up tomorrow, Kyle Hendricks for the Cubs, Joe Ross for the Nats, who has been pretty good, 3-0, 0.79 ERA. You're looking forward to this one.
Yeah, it's going to be a great weekend. Two of the best teams in the National League getting after it. Kyle Hendricks gets us hopefully moving in the right direction. See if those bats don't keep hot here back at home.
It'll be a fun one. Well, we appreciate you joining us here for Cubs Postgame Live, presented by Blue Cross Blue Shield. The Cubs sweep the Pirates at PNC Park and now come home for the next 14. We appreciate you joining us.
Make sure he's in bed by 8.
Sometimes I get scared.
Scared of what, Danny?
The things I can't see.
Got a weird feeling. Almost forgot. In case anything happens.
Dad, I got this.
Introducing Comcast Business Wi-Fi Pro. With next-level speed, coverage, marketing, and control features. Plus, Wi-Fi Pro offers what AT&T's Wi-Fi small site doesn't. Professional installation, advanced security, and millions of hotspots nationwide. Looks like taking your business to the next level starts with ditching AT&T. Give your business an edge with Comcast Business Wi-Fi Pro. Comcast Business. Built for business.
At Discount Tire, we'll get you the right tire at the lowest price for your vehicle. Get a $70 Visa prepaid card when you buy any set of 4 Michelin tires.
Now it's in the hands of the bullpen, and out comes Papa John.
It looks like he's taking this official pizza thing pretty seriously.
For just $6.99 each, get 2 medium, 2 topping pizzas.
Papa John's, the official pizza of Major League Baseball.
Now playing on DirecTV Cinema.
What happened?
I'm going to kill a man and kill my son.
The Revenant is nominated for 12 Academy Awards, including Best Picture, Best Director, Best Actor Leonardo DiCaprio, Best Supporting Actor Tom Hardy.
God giveth, God taketh away.
The Revenant. Movies start at Channel 125.
Why jump out of a perfectly good airplane? Why not? Chicagoland Skydiving Center was voted the best in the U.S. with a perfect safety record, a one-of-a-kind environment, and round-trip shuttle service from downtown Chicago. Come experience the greatest adventure in the area. Chicagoland Skydiving Center in Rochelle. Visit us at perfectlygoodairplane.com.
Welcome into the first episode of Beer Money this season, presented by Coors Light. I'm Kelly Kroll here in Yorkville at Pinheads, hoping some of these fans can knock out some serious sports trivia, and I'm going to try and get things rolling here.
Put me in, Coach. I'm ready to play.
This is Dave. Dave's in the house, and he is ready to go.
You're ready to go.
We're ready to go.
Yes.
You are going to do some spelling. And even though you're wearing the Cubs.
I'm Asian. English is not my first language.
Oh, no,
Let's
Dave.
Try this.
No. I feel very confident in your spelling capabilities.
All right.
We are, however, going to do the Bulls. Are you okay with that, since you're wearing a Cubs hat and all?
I'm going to try it.
Okay.
Yeah.
You can take an easy one to start with, and then you can go for the hardest one, or you can go for a medium one and go for the hard one. Now, the easy one's 10, so you end up with 110 if you get it all right. But if you go for the harder one, it's 120. So
Okay. You
tell me, which would you like to start with?
Let's go harder.
Harder. Enos Whatley.
Enos Whatley?
Yes.
Enos Whatley. Is there another description for the word Enos Whatley?
Oh, like you need to know what...
Can you use it in a sentence?
Right. No, I'm not a spelling bee connoisseur either.
What is the origin of
Enos
Whatley?
That's why I have the card, Dave. I have the card because
right,
I don't know
this.
These things.
Enos Whatley. E-N-U-S. Enos. Whatley. W. A-T-T-L-E-Y.
Sorry, I couldn't come up with anything better than that.
Is Enos Whatley on the Bulls?
Not currently.
Oh.
But this is any Bulls player.
Oh.
Did we trick
okay.
you?
Yeah.
E-N-N-I-S W-H-A-T-L-E-Y.
English is not my second language.
But Dave, it was fun.
Yes. Thank you.
Looking good, Joel. Looking good.
Got it?
Yes, yeah. That is our introduction. You can let go of the cheek, I know. So
thank
this
you.
Is Joel, and he is a huge Cubs fan, as though
yeah.
Yeah, as though that didn't show up. Did your dentist do that for you?